What Do All the People Know was an 80s song by the 80s band The Monroes.
The song What Do All the People Know was a 1982 one-hit wonder from The Monroes. One of probably the best 80s songs ever written, but not well recognized. But when you hear the song, you can't help playing and dancing along with it. The song never had a music video. Now you would think in 1982, you know, being on MTV, probably at its prime in 82, 83, would, you know, hey, the Monroes, God, they gotta have a music video. No.
My dad is a DJ and he likes to make music videos for songs, and the song never had a music video, so he had friends from the 80s that had their own band, and he just kind of put them with the song, and he posted it on YouTube, and it got a lot of hits because the song was, you know, it was a big song, and you know, they never had a video. So actually the lead singer of the Monroes, Tony Ortiz, got in contact with my dad. He commented on the YouTube video.
Never knew why they didn't have a music video for the song. So I decided to make my own music video for it and put it on YouTube. The lead singer of the group, Tony Ortiz, messages me on YouTube. He gives me his number. When I was talking to Tony Ortiz on the phone, I had asked him, you know, hey, you know, I really want to make a music video. I'm sure you guys have some sort of video footage someplace that you had a, you know, that you performed in the 80s. You know, at least give me something that I can work with, that I can put the original band in. He told me no. You know, he actually had toured with people like, you know, Journey, Greg Kin Band, Hall & Oates. And he, you know, these are good friends of his. And, you know, they all have music videos, but not the Monroes. I confronted Tony with that question. He informed me that basically they did a performance on the Merv Griffin Show back in the early 80s.
Right now, I want to introduce to you a San Diego-based band that is making its national television debut with us today. Their new single is called What Do All the People Know? And it's right off this terrific album titled The Monroes. Would you welcome The Monroes?
Gave me the dates, he gave me the actor that was the guest star, and sure enough, I had the performance, and I never knew I had it. A week later, he was here in our studio, and we were editing the video, and we were putting it together. And that's when it dawned on me, you know, hey, my daughter's a singer. Let's remake the song. I mean, a lot of artists did it.
My dad had the idea to redo the song and make it more of a modern pop kind of version, but kind of keep the 80s feel to it. And he said, yeah. So we met up with a producer, his name is Denzel Remedios, and he lived in Brooklyn at the time. And he actually produced the song, and we recorded with him. And, you know, actually when we were recording, you know, all the choruses I thought were the same. So on our way home, I remembered I was listening to the song again, and one of the choruses were actually different. So we had to drive all the way back to Brooklyn, and I had to record that whole part all over again. So after, you know, the song was done, he sent us a rough draft, and, you know, sometimes when you send, you know, you gotta fix and tweak things, so we fixed a little bit of it, and it was awesome. He did an awesome job. And so the song was done, we know we needed a music video because that's really important nowadays. So my cousin Brian Sella is the lead singer of the group The Front Bottoms, and he has a lot of music videos and we liked a lot of them. So we asked him, you know, who shot it, and he said Steven, so he was their camera guy. And we came up with a whole bunch of ideas, and we wanted to make it 80s and modern at the same time. So we did a lot of green screen shots with a lot of 80s backgrounds, and we did the green screen at Steven's studio, and it took a really long time. We had to go through outfit changes, accessories, makeup, hair. Everything was kind of 80s in a way.
Green screen was very difficult. The amount of times that I think Chelli had to sing that song about 20 times, because she had 20 different outfits on. Each clip of that scene, if you realize, is a different earrings, different top, different clothes, different hairdo, different makeup. And that was a main part of the whole video, is because that's what we wanted to make as a strict 80s theme. We really wanted to incorporate two things. We wanted to incorporate the 80s sound, which the song really does have, along with a very current music beat.
So as that was done, that took a while, and then we wanted to do like a party scene, because I'm a DJ, we wanted to kind of include that in the music video. So we shot that in my basement. We changed a lot of lights to make it look funky. We did a lot of disco lights and laser lights, because we want, like I said, more 80s and modern at the same time. And we put an ad in the newspaper because we wanted a lot of people here, and there were so many people, and you know, we can only have a limited amount of people, and we had to have them sign waivers. And you know, we wanted to make it look kind of like teenish, adultish in a way, and we had a lot of red solo cups.
The red solo cups turned out to be a big problem. It was part of our scene, it was the party scene, we needed to have it. Kids go to a party, that's what they use red solo cups.
A lot of the parents did not like that at all, so they wouldn't allow their kids to be in it, because we had beer pong and, you know, it was like a party, because I'm a DJ and they didn't like it. So we had to get a lot of the kids out, and, you know, that's just how it went. So we were really limited at that point.
Nevertheless, we had to scrounge around last minute and get at least 50 people to come in as extras, because we lost all our extras. You know, half the children that were coming in, the teenagers, were 16, 17 years old, which was what the video was based on. It was based on a 17-year-old having a party in their house, in a basement, you know, having a party. What came up with the idea for the party scene was Sean Paul had his video, Get Busy, and we decided to kind of take it from that, and that's how we did the party scene.
It worked out good though, because we had a good amount of crowd and it looked good. You know, as you shoot, you have to shoot in a certain angle in a certain way to make it look busier than it actually is. And we worked in a small area, and we made it look a lot bigger and congested at the same time. So, you know, we made it look bigger and funky, and the different shots we chose, the basement looked huge because it looked like we were in all different rooms.
We got a call from our actor that was supposed to be the main part, and he called in sick, and we had to get the production done on this day. So last minute, Chelli called one of her friends, and Matt was one of the people that she called, and he showed up and he came through. And I'll tell you, the video was a lot better with him than it was with the original actor. He did a great job.
I've known Chelli for many years now. She hired a whole bunch of actors for the music video she was doing in the studio. Last minute, the actor that she picked for the music video called out sick, so she decided to call me, and I came in and filled in a spot. It was a blast doing it. Had a great time. A whole bunch of friends came over. Whole bunch of the actors that she had for the music video weren't allowed to do it due to the solo cups, so I called a whole bunch of my friends. They came on down. We did the video. It was extremely hot in the studio that day. It was so hot in the studio that we had to keep changing outfits and drying them, because they wanted them for certain scenes so they didn't look wet. And it was a fun time, but extremely hot in the studio. Due to the short notice, I had to run out and get a whole bunch of outfits for the music video so I looked a part, so I didn't look out of place during the music video.
We ate, we rested, we partied, we worked really hard. You know, my friends were really cooperative, which was really good. And, you know, all different shots, all different scenes. And as we wrapped up, they worked on it, and that was it. It was finished. And like I said, with the song, you know, they send you a rough draft, and then you have to figure everything out. You know, what you like, what you don't like, what scene you want, what scene you don't want, because there were so many shots, you know, you have to tell them what you do and don't want. So, you know, it's just how it is. So then we went through them and we worked everything out.
Oh, the fish part. The fish, you know, if you look at the video, the music video, we had to put a fish in there. And the background on the fish is basically If you watch Rihanna videos, every one of her videos has got this mechanical fish in it. And I was laughing because I was really the only one that actually recognized the fish in the videos, only because I own the same fish. The fish comes from The Sopranos. There was an episode of The Sopranos and the fish was on there. And I had the same fish. And it was just like, it's pretty much just a goof. There had nothing to do with anything. We just were going to throw it in. That's something that we're going to be doing with all Chelli videos, is that we're going to be putting this fish in it. So you're going to be seeing the fish in all of Chelli's videos. So more power to the fish.
So as we finished the video, we wanted to add, you know, we wanted to make it more viral. So we put it on YouTube, and our producer put it on iTunes, and we had it on Vimeo, and we had it on Amazon. So we put it on Shazam too, because, you know, if it ever came on the radio, you know, somebody would Shazam it. Actually, I have friends that go to college and they work on the radio stations, and I had them put it on their radio stations, and that actually worked out really well too, because we got, you know, you could see who Shazams it and how many Shazam views you could get. So we got a lot of views from those.
The response that we got on the video was just tremendous. Everybody loved it. It's so good that the older generation can listen to the video and really love the song. And of course you got the younger generation that will listen to the song and love it as well. It really does meet all ages. It's perfect. It's exactly what we were looking for. Chelli's writing her own songs. She's coming out with a lot of new original material. I think she's definitely going to be heading in the right direction.
I'm a DJ, and I DJ in New York and in Jersey, and we do music videos as we DJ, so when I play the video, people always take a double take because they see the video and they see me, and then people come up to me and they're like, oh, is that you on the screen? This song is great. And, you know, as time goes on, I make other videos and I kind of incorporate me DJing and the video we made for What Do All the People Know, and I put it in other videos. So as I'm playing other videos, they see me on the screen DJing, and, you know, they take another double take and they're like, wow, that's her, that's the DJ. And, you know, in the city it's really cool because, you know, there's so many people sitting at the bar and they'll be watching the videos and they'll look up at me and they'll be like, that's you, that's the DJ. And, you know, I work really hard on music I make, and, you know, I performed in New York, I performed the song, and, you know, just hard work. Like I said, you need to work hard, and it's just how it is.